Hello. Today I'm going to talk about my project on traffic analysis using image segmentation. A lot of work has been done in this domain before, but however, there's no all-round solution for this problem of traffic that plagues us in day-to-day life. As we see here, in general, there's a lot of traffic and there's no proper management system in place as of now. Therefore, the image processing domain has been employed in order to evaluate such traffic schemes and develop a management tool so that it can better facilitate the positioning of traffic. So, my implementation, the output of it will help in order to develop traffic analysis models so that better traffic allocation will be done. As we can see here, there are a couple of existing approaches that are used for object detection. The VLO-Jones object detection approach, SVM classification, and gradient-based detection. However, as we see over here, all of them have a lot of pros and cons. Over here, we see that background subtraction, though it has a moderate to low accuracy, the computational time is pretty moderate. Optical flow, on the other hand, also has a moderate accuracy. Framing differencing also has high accuracy, however, the computational time is really low. Therefore, we kind of use a method wherein we take the best of these approaches. The proposed approach for my project is image segmentation and blob analysis. In this approach, what I plan to do is obtain a video of traffic, segment it into frames, and within the frames, I segment the images which are of interest to me. Over here, as we can see, we are detecting cars. In this image over here, this is a segmented image that we obtain, and we change it in the foreground and a background. So therefore, as we see over here, all the cars come in the foreground. Segmentation in general works wherein points of common interest and which are similar are linked together and form a similar region. Such a region is called a segment. These segments can be effectively used to detect cars. Over here, as we can see, this is my implementation and the output of the program that I have run. As can be seen in the image on the left, this is pre-processing that has been done. So wherein a blob analysis has been put on the frames of the video that has been processed. And we can see cars in the foreground. These cars and then further processed and all the noise that is there is removed so that effective detection of the cars can be done. As we can see on the right, once the cars are detected, we contain them within a green color square rectangular blocks. These are the results that I have obtained. As we see, there are a number of frames that I have broken down the image into and the speed which is on the y-axis and the number of frames on the x-axis. Hence, over here we see that from frame to frame, due to a lag in the video, there is not a smooth flow of the speed that has been detected of particular cars. Using highly complex segmentation algorithms will help evade such a problem. But since as this was a project, therefore we have seen that the speed over here of each vehicle is plotted. Now I will show you the implementation and the code. This is the MATLAB code that I have used. This code has been built upon the core MATLAB vision toolbox. I've used a couple of default functions in order to facilitate my project. I will run you through the code now. The vision toolbox has a number of functions that are readily available for a person to use. So initially, I start off by initializing the time. This variable over here lets me calibrate a particular video. This algorithm for any kind of video. Some videos are having traffic which is time lapsed, so the videos move faster than actual reality. So adjusting this helps to calibrate the algorithm so as to fit different types of videos. Over here, the foreground detector, as we seen in the PowerPoint presentation, detects the necessary objects, and it doesn't detect the object, but it differentiates it as a background and foreground. Here we use again the vision toolbox to read the traffic MP4, that is the video that I'm feeding in. Over here, what is done is the frames are broken. The video is broken down into frames, and each frame is played one at a time, which in a consecutive manner, which the user feels like as it is like a continuous video. However, actually, I'm just displaying frames. This part over here is again, as you can see, it's reading the next frame of the video and again applying the foreground detector, and I'm displaying the video now. I will run it so that the processing will start. Okay, sorry. The same thing, I had just renamed it. So as we can see over here, the video is playing of the video that I have input. I will further explain the code now. Over here, what we do is we use the IM open morphological function. What it does is it basically the IM is a morphological function. It cleans out an image, and we use the STDL function on it in order to remove unnecessary clutter in the image, and we obtain a smooth image without much of noise. Furthermore, we apply blob analysis. In blob analysis, it's segregated in two parts. As you can see, the detected cars over here, I shall go back to the code again. But over here, as you can see, the detected cars are being highlighted in green boxes. So as the video processes, you can see as the cars come by, each car is highlighted in a green box. Shall go back to the code. In blob analysis, as I said, the video is broken down, is processed in two parts. The first part is segmentation. The common regions are all segmented together, and then a centroid is obtained. This centroid helps to detect a car in the particular image. After this, we draw a box around using the centroid. Over here, what we do is, in order to calculate, this is the graph that has just popped up. We shall come back to that. In order to calculate the distance of the cars that has traveled, we over here initialize it to zero. This entire loop is what I just explained about. However, in order to apply it to every frame of the video, we have put it in a while loop over here, so it keeps iterating and doing the above steps over and over again for every frame. This is the part where I'm actually calculating velocity. So over here, I am calculating the distance between a particular car from frame to frame. After calculating the distance, I check for the speed with respect to the time that I set, that I've initialized at the start of the program. As can be seen over here, once we get the speed, we can plot it with respect to the graph that was seen over here. Again, with respect to number of frames, you can get the respective speed. This algorithm can be modified to cater to a number of different objects. So you can either use it for detecting a few number of cars or also increase the number of cars by increasing this entire the number of instructions over here. And last, we just plot the video, plot the results. And as can be seen, this is a plot that we have obtained of speed versus the number of frames. And an improvement to this code, in conclusion, I would like to say that is it can be used in traffic analysis and to further facilitate traffic management. And an improvement to this code could be in order to smoothen out the speed obtained from different cars is that you can apply a highly complex segmentation algorithm so that there won't be any break in the frames, and then you'll get a much better speed analysis of such of various vehicles. Thank you.